The evolution to cloud is quite clear. Actually, in our early days, we knew our wireless base stations were mainly deployed through the DRAN method. What is DRAN? We call it Distributed Wireless Access Network. Why is it called distributed? All our sites have two devices, BBU and RU. They are used to process our radio signals and digital baseband signals respectively. These devices are installed at different sites. When you go to the site and open it, inside our small room or inside a cabinet, there will be such devices. Of course, the radio unit is often now referred to as RU or AAU. They are installed outdoors on the roof. This was our early DRAN method, the traditional distributed architecture. The problem with this architecture is each site's BBU is independent. If they want to collaborate, it can only be done through the transmission network or the bearer network to achieve interconnection and collaboration in this way. But through the transmission network and the bearer network, when interconnecting and collaborating, there are still some limitations. For example, it's hard to control the delay. Achieving low delay is challenging. So later we had a plan called CRAN. We call it Centralized Wireless Access Network. We will centralize the baseband unit that processes digital signals at the base station, place it centrally, form it into a baseband resource pool. Then these radio units that process analog signals are extended by optical fiber. We put these radio units on the roof or installed on lamp posts or installed on towers. Then we connect it through the underground CPRI optical cable to a converging machine room. Then we put 10 BBUs, 20 BBUs together. The benefit of this is we can more easily achieve inter-site collaboration. At the same time, we also save some machine room resources. We know that the resources of the machine room and the site are quite expensive, right? In the city, if you want to rent a small room, the annual rent is quite high. So this is also a burden for operators. So through this centralized RAN, CRAN, we can save site resources and better utilize the collaborative features between sites to achieve certain collaborative gains, AH. This is our CRAN. Of course, in the end, the wireless test also needs to evolve to the cloud. We will split the original base station functions, split it into the centralized part CU and the distributed part DU. After this split, we can consider cloud deployment and our entire air interface. We call it the UU interface, right? This is our air interface. That is, between our wireless terminal and the wireless base station interconnection, we achieve it through this air interface. But this air interface has certain standards, because our Apple terminal also needs to access Huawei's network, right? This Xiaomi terminal also needs to access Huawei's network. So our UU interface is an open interface. This interface actually has many functions, right? We will have some physical layer functions. There will also be some MAC layer functions. Actually, we will also have RLC layer functions, PDCB functions. And we also have, of course, in 5G, there is an additional SDAP function. Above is our wireless resource control. Actually, this air interface, of course, above it, we will also have some NAS signaling and data. Let's take a simple look here. Actually, on the air interface of our site, we have divided it into so many layers. Of course, at the bottom, we will also have our radio unit, right? Radio unit, the interconnection between this radio unit and the upper layer protocol station is through our optical fiber, right? We call it CPRI. Of course, in 5G, we call it the ECPRI interface. In our early days, this RRU part, this radio part is actually through our what? Remote radio unit. Or this kind of what? This AAU radio unit. The functions above, where are they all deployed? Deployed in our BBU box. In the future, we will split the entire protocol station structure. We will split some of these functions that require high real-time requirements, split it into we split the entire network element once, put this PDCP including PDCP and above, we will put it in the CU in the centralized unit, then RLC and below will be put in the distributed unit. Because the closer to the bottom, the higher the real-time data requirements, and the upper layer, the real-time requirement for data processing is not particularly high. So why do we divide it like this? Because we want to split it into the part that needs real-time processing, the part that needs non-real-time processing, and the part that needs real-time processing. Then the future CU, the CU part, we split out. We can use what cloud deployment, deploy it in the data center, then the DU part will become one by one, what small box, it will become smaller and smaller, then hang it where we need coverage. So this is our wireless side in. the future, we will do this CU and DU split, centralized unit and distributed unit. The centralized unit mainly processes some non-real-time data, or for those with lower real-time requirements, then this DU part mainly processes some data that we require to be real-time, higher real-time data. Okay. In this way, we have such a wireless CU, and the concept of DU split in the future, this CU part, we will deploy it in the cloud. Then the benefits are brought by this is that we can reduce our room requirements. At the same time, we can also better implement some of these, some coordination between cell sites, because at this time, it's not necessarily the two BBU boxes of the past implemented through interconnection. At this time, it's everyone in a server in a cloud data center. Everyone can achieve it through some internal interaction. It can be achieved in this way. This is the value brought by our CU part, right? And this CU part of CURAN, it can be deployed with MEC. It can be deployed with MEC in this way. This is the value brought by our CU cloud deployment. As for the DU part, then it can be flexibly deployed on demand. This DU part, you can still deploy it on the site side, then through this fiber, CPRI fiber or ECPRI fiber, interconnect with our RF unit. You can also put this DU part, centralized deployment, on the convergence room side. Can also. What combine this DU part and RU part? Form a miniaturized box deployed on the site side. In this way, our future, this kind of deployment method after CU-DU separation is very flexible, can adapt to various business demand scenarios. You need to control the delay at how much do you have sufficient room resources. Do you have sufficient of these buried fiber optic transmission resources? We can all on demand. If your buried fiber optic transmission resources are insufficient, then you might consider using this traditional method. Combine DU and this RF unit part. Deploy the RU part together. If our buried fiber optic resources are sufficient, then we can consider use this CU and DU completely separate way to achieve. So in the future, our wireless side, after the split of CU and DU, the deployment method will be very flexible, meet the needs of operators for different network construction. And this is our wireless side, such a cloudification technique. These are the functions of our wireless side, or we say the functions of the air interface. We will split it in the future. Split. Out this CU and DU, after splitting, we will consider deploying the CU part in the cloud. Deploy the DU part in a small box. Of course, this process may take some time, because after we made such a split, it will put a lot of pressure on the existing wireless network engineers, because you need to have a certain this kind of cloud computing capability. The pressure of transformation may be relatively large, and the whole operation and maintenance method will also change. Maybe at the beginning, we won't consider this method. At the beginning, we may consider more of this DRAN or CRAN method. Future evolution direction will evolve towards cloudification. That is our wireless side. Will also evolve towards cloudification. So we will see the deep integration of IT and CT. This is our wireless network side. As for the deployment of CU, it will be very flexible. We can consider CU in deployed in the data center. Then a CU hangs many sites. I can also consider putting CU deployed in this converged room. Then go hang some DU network elements. Of course, the advantages and disadvantages are quite obvious. We deploy CU in a higher level data center. The advantage is that it can achieve a larger range of resource control, can achieve a larger range of resource sharing. But the disadvantage is that the delay will be relatively large, because we have to transmit from the middle to the base station RU, then transmit to DU and then to CU. The whole delay will be relatively large. So for delay insensitive business, we can consider using this deployment method. For some delay sensitive business, we can consider putting CU as close to the edge as possible for deployment. The advantage of this is that the delay is small. The disadvantage is that your range of resource sharing relatively small. This resource sharing pool is not so big. So this is also a balance. Whether we consider sharing or consider delay is based on our different business scenarios. Business needs can be flexibly selected for our CU deployment scheme. Okay, this is our entire network architecture change. That is from the core network side, carrier network side, and wireless network. We from these three dimensions. That is the three modules of our entire 5G network. Take a look at our entire network architecture change. We have a small question here. Welcome everyone to answer this question on our platform. Welcome everyone to answer this question on our platform.